12 of May 2024 Welcome all friends at the Dhamma. What different concentration and contemplation? Contemplation with understanding, with accept and understanding, knowing the way it is, not evolved. Know what you know, see what you see from heart, not thinking, but from thought, from heart, or pure awareness, or bare attention. It got attention, but attention and know the way it is, just know the way it is. Leave it there. Bare attention, know and leave it there. Okay, not concerned. Okay, not involved. Normally, when we do concentration, we will focus. For example, our breath and focus, how long breathing. This is concentration. You get calmness and stillness of mind. But contemplation, you get consciousness. More contemplation, it looks like you got reflection from awareness, not reflection from thought, reflection from awareness. I see, I understand now, I got it now, okay? This is contemplation. Pure awareness, bare attention. It got attention, but bare attention, no self. Okay? With bare attention, then you got clear knowing, clear seeing. So keep attention from your heart, not thought. Know your very natural way. With attention and pure awareness. Pure awareness, know the way it is and not involved. Know how breathing in, how breathing out. Knowing how. Just leave it there, knowing how. Knowing how, and then you kept understanding it arising, disappear. Leading in and leading out. Arising, disappear. Everything got changing. Arising, disappearing. And keep awareness more inverse. You can realize more arising, disappearing of your sensual pleasure, mental formation, and all mental phenomena. Just state of contemplation, knowing with awareness and not involved, knowing clearly and clearly knowing the mind self, knowing clearly and clearly knowing the mind self. Okay? Contemplation both object and the knower. That is, you got look within. Mostly you reflect on object outside. If not look within, you only reflect on what that, what this, what for, what meaning. This is object outside, not look within. you got only knowing what to know thing clearly, but you not clearly know your mind yourself. Okay, now clearly know your mind together. Your mind letting go or not? When your mind know something, normally your mind not let go. Your mind know something and then your mind got involved. Okay, got sensual pressure. Okay, so I use two words: knowing clearly and clearly knowing the mind itself. Knowing clearly and knowing clearly, breathing in and out, and clearly knowing your mind itself. Your mind still your mind clear knowing, or your mind got any sensual pressure? Okay. Then investigation into the mind, or look within in your mind. Okay, look within. You can develop investigation into your mind. Anything you got attached in your mind for a long, long time, you got seeing it already there for 1 year, 2 year, 20 year. Never forget. When you got look within, this make me attached for 1 year, 2 year. Now I know, let go, not attached. Then you get more look within. Even you let go this thing, something inside you still cannot let go. Okay, knowing clearly knowing, let go all attachment, even subtle, any defilement very subtle inside, let go. Okay. When you let go, then look within more. How to look within? You must awareness of gentle breathing, the way it is. The breathing will bring you to realize something. Okay, how the breathing can bring you to realize something? Just attention on breathing and not involved, not for your breathing. And just when you're not involved, you can know slow motion of breathing. The moment of breathing, you can know or slow motion. It open you, okay. It open. It look like when you do something really fast, quickly, you don't know your mind. But when you do in nice day, you know something. Okay. So. You just awareness of breathing, slow motion, every moment. Every moment you can know. My conscious more wake up. I conscious it wake up. Body conscious wake up. My conscious it wake up. Know something. Coming in, coming out, moment by moment. Then it's open the door. Okay? Open the door. More you can be mindful, know every moment, breathing in. But you can rely every moment. Breathing and pausing. Breathing and pause, breathing and pausing. You know pausing? Pausing. You're not immediately breathing in long. No, that you force your breathing. But breathing is going inside slow motion. Pause, pausing in between. More you know the pausing, that the every moment, and that the access, the door open inside, you can relax and you can look within. Okay? So keep awareness of breathing in every moment. Keep knowing how breathing gently, softly, slowly, in pausing and pausing and deep and pause. Then you got eye inside, seeing mental phenomena. More awareness of breathing in or breathing out, doesn't matter long or short. You got realization of pausing. The pausing more you realize, is more open your heart. And then you got look within. Look within whatever inside in your desire and attachment. A lot. You got anger, desire, passion inside, stirring. Okay? Stirring. It always tell you, come, come on, come inside. Okay? This is the heaven. No, it's not the heaven. It's sensual pleasure. Okay? Then do not go inside. You must keep more awareness of the whole body. That I make you basic meditation. Lean your back backward. So you need awareness, full awareness of body more and more to be able to go awareness inside and look within. And now we practice full awareness for that. You got body awareness more and more of the whole body. And then smile. You got eye awareness. Become conscious and sensing. Can you send your face smiling or not smile? Or smile or nice smile? Can you send? Can you send your sitting from body consciousness? And can you send into your mind with smiling? With smiling, smiling while you got consciousness in your mind. Look with it. Okay? So we develop smiling, joy and happiness, then you got look within from smiling heart. Something you cannot smile, deep inside you cannot smile. You got perception, a lot of attachment in your perception. This is mine, I cannot leave it, I cannot stay without it. Okay? I cannot let it go, cannot. You can realize something into your mind by look within. Or I give you technique how to look within. Listen to your heart. What really do you want? Look within. Okay. How to practice in daily life. Listen into your heart first. Before you do it, you really want it. Listen to your heart, and when you're doing, listen to your heart more and more. You need it or not? No, you don't need it. Let go. Just let people take it. Okay. Listen into your heart. why you think this way? You still, you really need it? No, I just want to play game with my friend, my boyfriend. Okay, no, not play game, not play game. You don't want, but what? You don't need, okay? Let go. So always listen to your heart, then you will got look within. Really, you don't need that. Need is you enough, okay? Plenty enough. Look within. This word you can search in Google. Look within. A lot in the Buddhist philosophy, okay? To teach us look within, then you can trust your heart, okay? Trust your knowledge, okay? Because in Buddhist philosophy, we not trust in any god, okay? God is your knower, okay? This is God interpretation. God is the Dhamma, okay? Trust in the Dhamma you can teach. And then we have the law of Dhamma. Law of Dhamma is the Dhamma that any less, any country, any people, Thailand, Australia, Africa, got the same result, okay? Got the same result, okay? Just learn. With look mindfully within. But before you get looking within, you just know clearly what you see and clearly knowing really this is what you want. Know clearly what you hear and clearly knowing this is really what you want, okay? Maybe you don't need anything. You don't need anything. You only survive by breathing, smiling gently. That's all. Breathing is what the necessity thing. The four necessity thing, and not only breathing. Four necessity thing, that is food and clothing and housing and medicine. You only need those four necessity, these four necessity. Okay? Any other thing other than food, housing, clothing, medicine, not necessary. May you may have or not have, okay, no problem. So you enough already now. And what is the main thing that you survive is your breathing. So always knowing how you breathe nicely, gently, and knowing how you consume the four necessity. So now, we just turn inwards, realize our breathing, nice, gently. Then we got look within. Something not necessary, our mind will go out with desire, attachment, and cannot come back. Then cannot look within, okay? If you just enough for this necessity. What not necessary? Okay, I don't need it. Okay. Then you got clear mind inside, wake up. If you away this, I want that, I want those, I want this, I want that, this. Oh, I want everything. Never. never got peaceful, okay? Never got peace in your mind, okay? Are you enough now? People never enough, okay? That's why you always suffering, okay? Now, breathing in, stay aware. Before you do concentration, put concentration on your breath and breathing. But contemplation, just stay aware. You got contemplation of how breathing and how feeling, how eating and how feeling, okay? And how thinking, how feeling and how knowing. It is necessary thing or not, okay? Now, just leave away all unnecessary things, okay? Leave away unnecessary things from your mind. And what you depend on is only your breathing. Breathing in become into your awareness. Sitting become into your awareness. Awareness, knowing, breathing, clearly, and clearly knowing the mind itself. When you got knowing clearly breathing, survive with breathing and aware, mindfulness of breathing, what happened into your mind? You got good knowing, clear knowing, not disturb. Knowing something else, you got disturb. Knowing that, knowing it, disturb. Knowing meaning, not disturb. So always stay on your breathing as home. Your heart need home, okay? And how to come back home. Breathing will bring you back home. Now we traveling a lot of country. You find home already? You find home here in Australia? You find home in Italy? No. Even you traveling around the world, you cannot find home because just inside. Now, when you find home inside, you got joy and happiness and bliss in your heart. I can rely you feel blissful now. And your mind will tell you by awareness. This is right. Okay? Your mind tell you by awareness. Enough, enough, enough. Now, just mindfulness of breathing. Awareness and mindfulness of breathing as whole. That means you don't need to close your eyes. Even you look at me, listen to my talk, just mindfulness and awareness of breathing as whole. Doesn't have to focus to breathing. It's not object, but it's your home. You focus me, listen to my talk, but mindfulness of breathing as whole. Awareness of breathing as whole. Then you got to look at me. So this session, opening eye and stay aware. Don't have to be aware. Stay mindful. Don't have to be mindful. Okay? Stay aware. Stay mindful of necessary thing of yourself. That is reading, and other four elements. You know by heart, because your eye look at me, but your heart know something inside. Just know breathing and all four elements. Actually, breathing is also one of the four elements. So, breathing will help you to realize other elements. So, knowing breathing as primary object. Before you try to learn more as much as you can, then you cannot come back home. as now today, I just tell you, learn as little as you think is necessary. Really. Then you come back home. You learn too much. Learn something else outside too much. Then you got disturbed. Actually, we don't need anything outside. We need only breathing. Breathing good, your health good. Okay, you got your happiness. Now learn as little as necessary thing that is your need. Remind yourself. Otherwise, your mind running out. Okay. Running out with doubt, with desire. Now, just remind yourself. Just depend on necessity that is your pain, and learn how it make you real happiness. Once you come back to your breathing, you can learn the reality of this body into four elements. Now contemplation already happened. Contemplation of this body into four elements. Only learning as little as necessary, that is your breathing. Only mindfulness of breathing as whole. Body not hard and mind not hard. Every time you come back to be aware of breathing as whole. Body not hard, mind not hard. You got real happiness. Open eye better, because if you close your eye, maybe you lost in the perception and it become dreaming. open eye, then you learn only little as necessary. That is your baby. Close your eye, you learn all the forest. Okay? But the Buddha said, we only learn the handful leaf in your hand, handful leaf in your hand. Okay? Not leaf in the forest. Just learn in your mind. Eye contact, it comes to your mind. Ear contact, it comes to your mind. Tongue contact, comes to your mind. Nose contact, comes to your mind. Body contact, comes to your mind awareness. Then into your mind. You still got breathing at home or not? You away with breathing or not? If you not with breathing, that means you go out with something, okay? Away with breathing. Very simple. You can relax. Are you away with breathing? Your happiness when you are away with breathing as home, as good friend. Every moment you breathing, but you never know. But you only know every moment, the present moment. Then you might come back. Turn inwards and look with it and clean all dirtiness out. Okay? So this session don't need to close your eyes because we develop awareness of breathing at home the whole day in daily life. The whole day you open eye, okay? Then open eye and aware and see. Even you know breathing is good friend, but sometimes you traveling to some other friend outside, come back. That not really good friend. When your friend outside make you happy, then sometimes they make you unhappy. Okay? But always breathing, when you come with your breathing, you are always happy. Stay aware of breathing as good friend. Then you got emancipation now. You can realize emancipation of mind, liberation of mind, and the freedom of mind. Always see the present moment. Always see the present moment, that's all. Sometimes in front you got table, you got microphone, you got telephone, and you got master. But you see not all the present moment. You see only master, but you not see microphone. You not see telephone. Can you see more and more the present moment? Not only master sitting here. There are many things with master. Can you see? Observe how to stay at the present moment. Observe and notice surrounding. Seeing master and observe and notice surrounding around you. More you can notice and observe surrounding around you, it will bring you to the present moment. simply. Otherwise, you look at master and then you have to pay attention to master to stay at the present moment. Okay. Just see more and more everything in front. By mindfulness, observe, notice, notice, observe. Then you can see something changing. Today, there is master, there is telephone, there is microphone. If tomorrow you come, no microphone, no master. Master fly to Brisbane already. Okay. Learn the present moment. Then you always look within. If you not learn the present moment, you always look outside. Okay? You forget look within. More you look within, you can rely what defilement you still attach. And what and who you still attach for long, long time. And now, leave it away. Let go, not attached to anything, because it's not here, the present moment. The present moment is only you are with master and friends in the Dhamma. Now observe, observe. More you observe, you might not turn outwards. When you more observe, you might always turn inwards, 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 inwards. And then you might look within. With it. Whatever inside, not good or unwholesome feeling, leave it away. Okay. So we call investigation into your mind, seeing into the clear mind, the nature of mind. Now you cannot see the nature of mind because so many things you got. Thinking, bringing into your mind. So just know the present moment. Then the present moment is only a monk in front of you. No boyfriend, no girlfriend, no children. Okay? Then you can leave it away easily by seeing clearly the present moment. And more you see the present moment, you're doing nothing. You're only sitting, relaxed, and breathing. Just always here, knowing here and now, relax and sitting. You got more consciousness. It turn upwards. Before you got attached or got stuck with hatred, passion, desire, anger, attachment. Now it released and it turned upwards. It looked like the door opened. No, only here and now, only. Here and now, only you are sitting with friend and listen to Dhamma talk from a monk. No, here. I am also knowing here, I just sitting, relaxing, and giving talk, and have nice breathing, knowing here. And more knowing here, inward, how doing, how feeling, how breathing nicely, gently, how feeling good inside, good or not good inside, knowing inside, more and more, more and more. Your mind away, keep inwards. That is on the way to the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha. Keep outwards, go outward. That the way to your wife, husband, children, friend, business, or whatever, and make it disturb too much. Got too much thing, okay? 15 verse. Knowing too much thing very heavy. Okay. What is knowing now you are sitting and breathing? This is real happiness. And if you're walking, just knowing now you are walking and breathing. And if you are sitting and eating, then know you are sitting and eating. Always stay at the present moment. Know only the present moment, not lost in thought into the past and future. Okay? Then you got the shining mind, the brilliant mind. It looks like a big mirror. Wake up, mirror, wake up. With good exposure, with the light of wisdom. Okay? Look within in this way. Don't need to close your eyes. Because Dhamma is in your life. That means every day, daily life, work and activity, you open eyes, Dhamma is there already. By knowing only the present moment, no desire, no passion, no craving, no hatred, no delusion. Okay? You feel very light and freedom and real happiness, and you got peace in your mind. You know too much because you watch YouTube every day, watch Netflix every day, know too much. Okay? Just keep quiet. Not too much. In seclusion, stay quiet in seclusion. Thing will happen, okay? Don't worry. If it happened, it happened. What will be, it will be, okay? Just learn now you are breathing, sitting, breathing. What you are doing now? Sitting, listen to Dhamma and breathing. After anything else, don't have to pay attention. That's why you too much knowing. Then you have to do concentration on one object because you too much learn knowing, okay? But you just know the point, knowing only the present moment. Even opening eye or closing eye, the present moment is now you're sitting and breathing. Open eye, you knowing sitting, breathing. Closing eye, you know sitting and breathing. And close your eye. Know as little as you can at the present moment. As little as only the present moment you are breathing in, you are breathing out. Knowing clearly the present moment you are breathing in, you are breathing out, and what happened to your mind, clearly knowing the knower. It got freedom. Know only the present moment, not here and now, don't pay attention. It's already the past or the future, no here and now, only the present moment. So Dhamma is the practice in your life, daily life. It's the way of life, way of living. It's not only sitting and closing your eye. It's not different from the present moment in daily life. How you know now in daily life? Just know only the present moment. In this way, you don't have to forget your breathing anymore because you know the present moment only. Because you know too much thing. When you practice, you have to try to focus only one object. But if you just bring Dhamma practice in your life, know only the present moment. Then you don't have to put concentration on any object. But you got already clear mind, clear awareness, mindfulness of every moment, your body movement and action, your verbal speech, your thinking, you know, listening, you know, sitting, you know. So you only develop knowing is here, not thinking, knowing. What you got knowing now? You got knowing four elements. That's right. More you got knowing from the beginning, you know this body, this is me, this is my body. More knowing is not you, it's only four elements. And more you know four elements, you can realize consciousness element or the noble wake up. Yeah? And wake up with emptiness or space element. We call space element. Space. Okay? Because space in between. Okay? You got space or not? You got atmosphere or not? Okay? And you got four element, fire element, water element, air element, earth element, and who know this thing? Consciousness element. And it got space everywhere. Oh, then you knowing even your body got four element, consciousness element, and space. Space in between the four element, okay? Now, then you can realize consciousness element and space. Then, if you want to go to calmness, just go to space. All emptiness, this is calmness. Okay? But if you want to go to wisdom, going to consciousness element, you got knowing. Only knowing, with understanding and not attached. And if you just go together, calmness and wisdom, just away, stay in this present moment, seeing the four elements by standing on space. On space, then with knowing from consciousness element. You standing on desire, you standing on anger, you standing on perception. Can you standing on space or emptiness? Yeah, standing on space and emptiness, then you can see what not emptiness, okay? You can see four elements clearly. If you standing on space or we call emptiness, okay? But on space or emptiness, develop knowing in emptiness together. Knowing in emptiness, knowing in space, what you knowing? Four elements. Now you know where is consciousness element, and now come back to consciousness element by standing on space or emptiness. Stay calm and empty on space or emptiness. And knowing the present moment of four elements. The present moment, what you know is only four elements. You are four elements. Food also four elements. Four elements eating four elements. Four elements drinking four elements. Four elements talk to four elements. Then you got spaces, more space, or more emptiness. Emptiness of self or emptiness of attachment. And you know you are four elements. You listen to four elements, I'm four elements as well. I talk to four elements. Four elements talk to four elements. Then how you know? You know from consciousness element. Consciousness element and regarding all emptiness. Emptiness of self. Not emptiness by make it empty, empty, empty. Not empty like that. It's emptiness. Emptiness of self attachment. Now, when you regard yourself for a man, everything around you for a man, you got more oxygen. You breathing fresh air more and more. Because you regard yourself for a man, then for a man of the body come with the present moment for a man outside, breathing in, breathing out. And now just review your understanding and learning today. Dhamma in daily life, you must be able to develop Dhamma in daily life with eye opening. But sometimes if you want to practice meditation, closing eye, just not different, okay? Okay, just knowing the present moment. Otherwise, when you not practice Dhamma in daily life, when you closing eye, you have to do concentration. Big job, okay? If it the same, then no difference. Just mindful awareness of daily life work and activity. And now we finish today's session. Sathu, sathu.